And this video might be helpful for you regarding setting up a very simple electrical system, assuming that you have very little knowledge about electrical stuff. And you're not ready to talk about solar panels just yet. All you want is a little bit of power so that you can run some lights and maybe use a water pump to have a shower, or just to pump out water into a sink inside your van. So you need power to run one of these things. This is a submersible water pump, so you can submerse it into a body of water and it will just pump out water when power is supplied to it. What I would recommend is that you use some timber like this to set up all of your stuff. It just makes things very organized and easy to work out. So this is where energy is stored, electrical energy is stored in the battery, right? Batteries have positive and negative terminals. And this protects the battery from getting completely flattened out. If the battery gets completely flattened out, then it will damage the battery. This is a conventional battery. It's nowhere as good as a lithium battery. The new lithium batteries are so much better because you can drain them down to zero and they don't get damaged. They recharge very quickly as well. They're just great, but they're still very expensive. So here's your battery. This protects your battery, makes sure that it never drains out. This measures how much energy you're using. It's known as a capacity indicator or an ammeter. And it's really good because it gives you a graphical interface as to what's happening. Right now, there's some charging going on. This is a battery charger that's connected to power. So I'm assuming at this stage, you may be interested in camping in a caravan park. So the caravan park, if it's a powered site, you have access to power, you'll be able to recharge your battery while you were there. Of course, it's better to have solar, but I'm not talking about solar just yet, but I have room here for a solar charger in future. Now, one of the most important things to remember when you're doing any kind of electrical work is to have fuses. So you need to learn how to crimp, get cables made up like this. There are many YouTube videos on how to do this. And so this is a fuse, a 60 amp fuse in this case, so that if by accident this should meet this, there could be an explosion or a fire even. So be very careful. And that's why you need to have a fuse. So if accidentally this, the positive were to make contact with the negative, the fuse would blow and there would be no danger. So that's the first fuse I have, very close to the battery itself. And over here, I've got another fuse. This is also a fuse, a 30 amp fuse. And this fuse is a self-resetting fuse. So this fuse, this type of an older style fuse blows, you need to change it. This one here, just wait for a few minutes, let it cool down and it'll start working again. So as you can see, the positive is connected to the positive terminal here. And that's protected by the fuse I just mentioned. And from here, I've got a few connections going on. One connection is going to the battery protector where it says red, 12 volt positive, that one there. I've also got, what else have I got here? Oh yes, I need some power for the meter itself. So that's the second connection. Okay, and this black cable here is connected to the charger. And then I've created a positive bus. So all of your lights, water pumps and everything should, the positive source should come from here. Okay, so this is all the positives from the battery. And that's a negative bus over here. Can you see? And to power any device such as this, you'd have the positive going to here and the negative going to there. And there's a little switch here. I didn't realize that. And same thing with the light. The light would also be connected positive and negative. Now, just to demonstrate this, if I turn the light on like this, if I were to turn this off, then power supply is cut off. And what's happening right now is a charge is going on from the battery charger. So let me cut that off. So I'm going to disconnect the power supply here. And you'll see that will stop flashing. So this is a wonderful visual indicator as to what's going on. I highly recommend that you invest in one of these things. Otherwise, you have no idea as to where you stand. You have no idea whether your battery is drained, whether your battery is charging up, how much power you use, how much more power you have left, so on and so forth. So let me go on and turn the power on. And as you can see, once the lights go on, the consumption increases. And you can see that this light is consuming approximately 1 amp of power, 1 amp hour. That means every hour it uses that 1 amp hour. And if I turn this off and the light goes off, then there's a very, very tiny amount of power still being used just to keep this thing going. So that's a very, very simple setup. I hope that's been useful for you. For this to work, you need this. So this terminal goes back to the battery, and everything else, every other load of yours requiring a negative connection should be on this side. And so what this does, it measures how much current is flowing between these two brass buttons here, and that gives you a reading. It's a very useful device because you can tell your tell this device how much amp hours your battery has, what size your battery is. You can change this. It can show you the current voltage of the system, and it also shows you percentage fullness of your battery. So once again, in summary, you've got your battery protector, something which indicates your use, some way of recharging your battery, and all of your different loads. It can be a USB charger, it can be a light, it can be a water pump. Hope that's useful. Once you've got this set up and you're ready for the next step, would be to add solar panels. You'd put in the solar charge controller here, connect your solar panel here, and once again, you'll be able to see the sun charging up your battery, and you'll be able to tell exactly how much. So I hope this has been useful. Don't forget to click like and subscribe if you like videos like this, if you found it to be useful.